ईश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis sitting with us around the world. Today I'll expand on the subject, the space we carry inside, how it directly affects the reality we and the people around us perceive. In Sanskrit, we have two beautiful words, drishti srishti, srishti drishti. Either you cognize as seeing what exists, or creating what you want to perceive, what you want to see. Please understand, the subject I am talking is a very subtle, very important truth. I may need your listening completely. I wanted you to be complete, settle down. The space you are carrying, the space we carry inside, directly affects the reality which we experience and the people around us experience. हमारे अंतर आकाश कैसे सीधी तरह से हमारे वास्तविकता को प्रभावित करती है, उसके बारे में बात करेंगे. इंटरनलाइज दिस टू वर्ड्स, बिकॉज आई एम गोइंग टू यूज दिस टू वर्ड्स अगेन एंड अगेन. दृष्टि सृष्टि, सृष्टि दृष्टि. Srishti drishti means you believe what is seen by you. You see what is. Drishti srishti means, please understand, drishti srishti, srishti drishti. Drishti srishti. Drishti means seeing. Srishti means creation. Sometime you believe what is, the creation is, and you are seeing it, which most of us cognize most of the time. Most of us always feel it is there, I am seeing, so I am caught, I don't know what to do. Feeling powerless. You put all the blame on what is. It is there, what can I do? Please understand, when you cognize it is there, I am seeing, already you are lost. You lost the game. You are starting the losing war, losing battle. It is like you trying to conquer your wife by argument. No, it can never happen. It can never happen. You may be a great lawyer, I have seen great liars. You can be great liar in the court, convincing any judge with any argument. But you can't win the argument in the house. The moment you cognize what is perceived by me, the possibility for transformation is closed. The possibility for enlightenment is closed. But good news is, it is not true. Please understand, the moment you cognize what is seen by you, bad news is the possibility for enlightenment is closed. Possibility for transformation is closed. Good news is it is not true. You are not seeing what is. You are only seeing what you want. It is always drishti srishti. You create what you want. It is not you see what is. You create what you want. But so unfortunate, human beings are in a space of such an unfortunate level. Very strongly you believe what is only is perceived by you. Especially when you cross 35, 40, when the possibility for new way of thinking becomes difficult, and already with the old way of thinking you built your personality. Now if you change those basic truths, you have to change your whole existence. You have to change your whole life, which is too much. Please understand, your every suffering and every ignorance is because of your decision which you made due to some other vested interests. Why you do not want the transformation? Because transformation means now literally the earth on which you are standing for last 40, 50 years will shake. Many things with which you consoled yourself as you are a success, that's one of the biggest delusion we create around us. We cannot bear the truth that we are not success. So we have to constantly make us believe we are success. To make us believe we are success internally, we go on planning, looking, altering, and continuously convince us to believe the ideas with which we built the life is right. See, so many people of my age and my colleagues are all, don't have all these things. I have all this, so I am successful. But one corner of your mind laughs at you. No. But the other side, no, I am successful. It's a complete... You don't know which side to support. person who finally lands into the utter confusion. Which side can I support? One part of me claims and consoles me I am success. One part of me claims and condemns me as a failure. Which part can I support? If you are in utter confusion, be very clear. The seeking has started in you. If you have not yet faced the confusion, the possibility for transformation is not yet opened. First thing any person has to face in the life for enlightenment is the utter confusion. Am I successful being or am I failure? As long as you are convinced, you see what exists, you will not have this confusion. And we are also afraid of entering into the confusion. We do not want to rock the boat. No. It's all going well. Why unnecessarily create problem? You do not want to come to terms with the reality. You do not want to take any argument which is raising in you to the logical conclusion. Please understand. How many of you cognize, how many of you postpone taking any logical arguments in you to the logical conclusion? When the arguments raise, you postpone it, you push it aside. You don't want to take it to a logical conclusion. You suppress it, you push it under the carpet. How many of you do this in your life? Raise your hand. It's life. Look in. Anything you push it under the carpet without taking to the logical conclusion becomes mechanism which restrains your possibility. Please understand. The pattern of not reaching the logical conclusion is what I call life imprisonment. It is life imprisonment. Constantly pushing things under the carpet, under the carpet, under the carpet. You don't understand. Under your carpet now a big volcano is there. You are sitting on a volcano. How will you be in rest? How will you be in restful awareness? That is why you are not able to sit with you. I have seen people who are not able to sit with themselves. See, when I started this sannyas sampradaya, means a large number of people, youngsters getting trained and initiated, getting initiated into sannyas, the first biggest problem I have to face is I need to teach human beings to sit with themselves. Meditation is secondary. I used to wonder, when I travel all over the world, especially when I go to the countries like Nepal. See, Nepal has only 6% Buddhist population, 83% Hindu population. But if you walk in the streets of Nepal, anywhere, you will see scores of Buddhist monks walking. How many of you had been to Nepal? Then you all know what I am talking. You will see so many Buddhist monks walking. But you won't see even few Hindu sannyasis walking. How many of you understand what I am saying is the truth? You can see in many countries, so I used to wonder, why, what happened? Have we lost trust on the sannyas tradition? Have we taken up that sannyas is not required for enlightenment or teaching the religion, spiritual tradition? Have we distanced ourselves with the sannyas tradition? When I started studying, I realized the basic truth of ability to sit with ourselves, we forgot to learn and teach that truth. We were too busy in building huge temples. Our leaders were too busy in creating infrastructures, creating disciples, creating so many things. Unfortunately, we forgot to teach human beings to come to terms with the reality. And the funny thing is, huge infrastructures Hinduism has, but the inspiration and infrastructure is always separate. See, all the gurus, enlightened beings, when they start their mission, they have to spend their whole life in building the infrastructure. By the time they build the infrastructure to teach, their life is over and they are dead. They leave the body and go away. And the infrastructure lies dead and waste. And some other master comes, he has to spend his whole life in creating infrastructure. Then finally, by the time he is ready with the infrastructure to reach the world, he is dead. This is one of the biggest problem Hinduism is facing. The reason is the mainstream sannyas tradition has not become alive. Why the mainstream sannyas tradition? The mainstream Hindu society does not feel the need of the sannyas tradition because we have not learned to sit with ourselves. We use the religion only to the extent of makeup. Makeup is not surgery. It is just, we are there and little better we should look, just for that. We are there, we need some few things for that. How can religion help? Little health and little peace and one or two things, whatever I want should happen. For that, if the religion helps, that's enough. I go to a temple or a deity or a god, goddess, and get some boon, that's enough. Religion has to start from the space of restful awareness, the conflict resolution, ability to take our logical thinking to the logical conclusion. Please understand, in Buddhism, they start with restful awareness. Of course, it is not that Buddhism does not have a ritual to receive what you want from a god, receive a boon from a goddess. The kamya type, that means the praying what you want. It's not that Buddhism doesn't have, but Buddhism doesn't start with it. Unfortunately, we start with it. We have to start with restful awareness. We have to start with carrying the right space, we have to start taking our logical questions to the logical conclusions. This should become the mainstream Hinduism. See, all religion will have both component, the knowledge component, means enlightenment science, and prayer component, consolation. You don't have a job, pray to the God and take a job. You will have a job. You don't have a health, pray to God and He will give you health. That is one component. And cognitive shift, the spiritual knowledge, the enlightenment science, that is another one component. All I am trying to tell is, I am not here to judge one is lower, one is higher. No, I am not saying. Where else you will go if you can't pray to God? You have to pray to Him only. But the teaching of religion has to start with the science of restful awareness by helping human beings to create the right space inside. The concept of prayer should come as next. First, human beings should be taught to create the right space inside. The mainstream Hinduism should start with the teaching of creating a right space. Please understand, the space you create inside is so powerful, it can straight away affect the way you experience life and others experience life. I think when I talk about the space we create inside, many people think, okay, he's talking, let me sit. I should not talk now, I will keep quiet. Many think it is going above your head. Let me define that word. Space you create inside means how you feel things are going to be is what I call space you create inside. If you are very clear, your space is already in a low energy, that anyhow, whatever I am going to do is not going to work out, it is not going to be successful. Already you dictated, you gave the plan to the cosmos. My life, I want my life like this only, as a big failure. Please do it and give. And cosmos will stitch it and give you. The space you carry inside is not the effect of the happenings of your life. It is the order you are giving to the cosmos. You may blame, no, I am in low mood because of so many failures, continuous failures happened in life, my life, you don't know. If you are in my shoes, then you will understand why I am like this. Whatever reason you may give about the space you are in, but you need to understand the seriousness of the space you are in. Please understand, the space you are in is the order you give to the cosmos to prepare your future. Listen, it's like a, in the hotels, how you order, you see the menu card and order, I want this, this, this. The inner space you carry is also an order you give it to the cosmos. I want this, this, this way my life is. Whatever you carry in your inner space is a possibility. If you are carrying sadness, you are ordering the society, you are ordering the cosmos for a bigger sadness to come in your life. If you are carrying a joy, you are waiting for a bigger joy to come in your life. if you are carrying fulfillment in you, completion in you, you are ordering the cosmos to bring bigger completions in your life. So understand, anything you carry inside, if you are carrying an inability, yes, I have a wrong inner space, I am depressed, but I don't know how to change, that is a one more inner space. You are ordering the cosmos to give you more powerlessness. You are a human being. You can't afford to say, yes, I am in problem, I don't know how to transform. No. You have to transform. You can't afford to say, yes, yes, I am hungry, but I don't know how to get food. Then die. That is a solution. You can't afford to give up on you. You can't afford to be powerless. You have to stand up. You have to find the method. You have to transform. That is the only way life is possible. Life is possible. Dhyan se suniye. Please listen. The space you carry has to be changed. One more good news about the space is you can change it this moment, because the space is not grass. Grass things takes time to clean. Subtle things can be cleaned immediately. Please understand, if the earth is dirty, if the ground is dirty, it takes time to clean. But if the air is polluted, easily you can clean it just by one spray. Subtle things are easier to be cleaned. Your inner space is such a subtle thing. One right declaration is enough, you are free. One completion is enough, you are free. You are out. You are out of that low mood you are carrying. You are out. Of that wrong inner space you are carrying. You are out of the deep negative cognition you are carrying. Only one thought of fear can make you unsettled. Only one thought of lust can make you excited. Only one thought of your enemy. Only one thought of your enemy. Please understand. Only one thought of your enemy can aggravate anger in you. If this is the case, only one thought of completion can purify your inner space. If only one thought of lust can excite you, if only one thought of fear can agitate you, if only one thought of your enemy can bring anger in you, then only one thought of completion is enough to transform your space. Somehow we don't believe that last statement. No, everything else looks very logical. I experienced. But the last statement, is it true? then we say, no, you are an enlightened being. Maybe for you it is possible, not for us. See, whenever you feel you are now cornered to transform, you immediately push me aside. No, you are a great person. You are an enlightened being. You are an incarnation. You can be, it is possible for you, not for a normal people like us. I always feel, sometimes people, to escape from my teaching, they show devotion. Please understand, even devotion, if it is for wrong reason, it cannot transform you. It has to be for right reason. It has to be for right reason. First thing you need to know, the inner space can be transformed. Inner space can be transformed. I'll guide you into a very simple process. All the Sadhana TV viewers, please understand, all the Sadhana TV viewers, just take few moment. Lotus TV viewers, take few moment and look in what kind of a space you are in. All the participants of NDY, you can just look in what kind of space you are in. Is it peace or sleepy or dull? Are agitated? What kind of a space you are in? Look in. Be sensitive. Be aware of that space. Just 2 minutes. Close your eyes and try to be aware. Take these few moments to bring your awareness to your inner space, because now experientially I'm going to support you, help you to transform your inner space. Yes. Now, please understand, what you feel with you, about you, is somebody else can be responsible for it? No. It is your boundary. Your inner space is your boundary. Nobody else can be responsible for it. It's only you who can be responsible for it. It's only you who can be responsible. Even if you say somebody is a reason, that person is not suffering. Suffering is to whom? To you. So when something is affecting you, whether you are a reason or not, you are only responsible. It is not that always the person who is reason will take the responsibility. Many times, where you are the reason for the mess, you don't take the responsibility. Now it is time, whether you are reason or not, whatever is inside your inner space, you are responsible. Aapke antar akash aapki seema hai. Isiliye uska uttar daitva keval aapki ka, किसी और का नहीं. You are a reason or not, you are responsible. The moment you decide you are responsible for the inner space you are carrying, now you know you have to change it. You need to change it. And your inner space is nothing but the words you repeat again and again within you. Am I right? Is there anything else? So now, decide consciously you will repeat the right words. Consciously you will repeat the right words. You will say, no, I tried this, but again I fail, forget and go back to the same old wrong words. How many times you tried? 10,000 times you repeated negative words. So try now at least 10 times to repeat the right words. You may fail 10 times, nothing wrong. Because of the pattern built by you, you are failing. Now try 10 times. Bring awareness. Decide. You are reason. You are responsible. And you have to change it because it is affecting you. Your wrong inner space is directly affecting you. So naturally, whether you are the reason or not, whether somebody else is the reason or not, you have to change it. You are responsible. Aap karan ho ya na ho, aapke antar akash ka uttardayitva keval aap hi ka hai. इसीलिए उसे केवल आप ही परिवर्तित कर सकते हैं. इट इज यू हु इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल. इट इज यू हु इज द रीजन. द इनर स्पेस यू कैरी हैज टू बी ट्रांसफॉर्म्ड बिकॉज based on the inner space you take the decisions. Please understand, if you are in a peaceful, relaxed mood, even if the big risks, dangers, difficulties, you take the right decision with so much of passions and you expand in the life. If you are in agitated mood, suffocating mood, even small risks you don't take and you throw tantrum, you throwing tantrum is going to affect only your life. How many of you feel just because of the wrong inner space you missed your business deals, your expansion in the life, growth in the life, in many possibilities, in many dimensions? Raise your hand. So then all of you know the importance of the right inner space. Now I wanted you to understand, whether you believe it or not, whether you accept or not, how many millions of reasons you give or not, there are some things which can't be changed. Please understand, I have a good news for you. Whether you believe it or not, accept or not, understand or not, you are God. Your inner space is all powerful. It carries the DNA of Aham Brahmasmi. Your inner space carries the DNA of Aham Brahmasmi. Sometime, how many arguments you may give, constitution cannot be changed. Same way, how many arguments you give for the side of you are not God and you are not divine and you are not all powerful, you may give million reasons. No, I wanted to have a cup of coffee, I am not able to get, then how can I be all powerful? No, all your reasons are that level reason only. No reason is a solid, worthy reason. I wanted to have a tasty coffee and there is no sugar in the coffee, then how can I be all-knowing, all-powerful? I don't even know what is happening in my next person's mind. in my spouse's mind, how can I be all-knowing? You have a very silly reasons to deny the possibility of your inner space. Please understand, you never tried to explore your inner space. Before even trying, how can you deny? Ramana Maharshi gives a very beautiful example. He's from my native place. People go on saying, God is not there, this extraordinary energy is not there. He is just walking behind you. You never look back even once. You never looked in even once. But you go on denying his existence. You never try to work on your inner space with authenticity and integrity even once. I tell you, I'm not talking for pride or ego or anything. I'm just stating the truth and fact. Many times I express the Ashtama Siddhis and extraordinary powers not to show something I'm extraordinary, just to show it is possible for you. It is possible for you. Nothing is required other than carrying the space. When he can do, I can do. That's all. To learn swimming, you don't need anything. You need to see somebody swimming and cognize, when he can do, I can do. That's all. When he can do, I can do. Then you will simply know which leg to move first, which leg to move next. Which hand to move first, which hand to move next. Other than, without that, how many volumes, encyclopedia on all types of swimmings, even if you read that, you won't be able to learn swimming. It's just a knack. It is just a knack. Same way, the space of possibility is just a knack. You need to see somebody playing with it, doing it, and you need to know, when he can, I can. When you know somebody is swimming, when you see somebody is swimming, oh, when he can, I can. That's the first step. Second, let me jump and do what he is doing. But the jumping where, no, if I drown, what will happen? One disciple jumped like this into the river and started screaming, Master, save me, save me, save me. Master was standing on the bank. He said, save yourself. No, teach me all your Vedanta later on. Now please save me first. I have to be alive. Only then all your Vedanta I can practice. You do all that when I am on the, you experiment on me, teach me all that when I am on the ground, not on the water. Save me, I am drowning. Master very coolly said, save yourself. Then he started screaming, save me, save me. Then Master thought, it's a big nuisance, and he shouted, fool, stand up. In that fear, the disciple did not know what he is doing. He stood up and he saw water is only up to knee level. I tell you, all your problems are only like this. It is just your decision to stand up in your inner space. But the fears you carry look so real. So real. You say, no, I cannot stand up. I can't stand. You you are telling, I will listen. I'll worship you also. But I cannot stand up. Don't tell me to stand up. I'll do anything else. Exactly what you don't want to do, you have to be, you should be made to do that. Forcibly. Because that is where your inauthenticity is there. I have seen people will tell, I'll do everything, Swamiji, not just this one. Recently in the Kumbh Mela, one of my disciples, she said, Swamiji, I'll do everything. I'll do panchatapas, I'll meditate, I'll attend any meditation program, anything. But just don't tell me to go to a place where the birds are coming. See, in the Allahabad, if you see Sangam area, a lot of birds will come very low. If you go in the boat, the birds will almost come near your head. How many of you have seen? She has a engram, a strong pattern, fear of birds. She says, only thing, don't tell me to go in that boat to the Sangam to take bath there. I said, which you resist, that will only persist. I said, this is your tapas. You don't need to do anything. Just only do that. You will get into the boat and go round and round in that area till enough birds come near you. Then take bath and come back. This is the tapas for you. She literally started rolling on the ground. No, don't tell me that. I said, only if you do that, you will have sannyas. Not before that. Anything you ask will happen only after you do this. Finally, with all her fear, shivering, everything, she went. When she came back, I could see she was a new being. Just new being. Please understand, what you resist only persists in your life. It is just pattern. You need to look in. What is the pattern you resist strongly in your life? What do you think you can't do? You can't manage? If you look, that will be the exact thing which stops you, binds you, and keeps you in the life imprisonment. It may be as small as fear of birds. I have seen one of my devotees has a fear to come up to the stage. He can't even see this height. When I digged out, why you have fear? You don't need to talk, just sit. But he will not come up to the stage. Because while he was very young, when he was 2-3 year old baby, he was throwing tantrum. His mother put him on the dining table, threatening, keep quiet or you will fall. See, for a child, dining table is too high. So that moment, the fear of height started in him, the height phobia. Still he is carrying it. If you look inside, the reason for your low inner space, powerless inner space, will be some root pattern, root thought pattern. Break that. Reclaim your freedom. Declare your freedom. Raise your inner space to the peak. Joy, fulfillment, excitement. Please understand. When Svetaketu is the Upanishadic character, when he was initiated by his guru said only 9 times tattvamasi tattvamasi tattvamasi. Svetaketu became enlightened. Then why, even if you listen 9,000 times tattvamasi, you don't become enlightened? No, carrying the right inner space. On the rock, seed cannot sprout as a tree. The right fertile ground only, the seed can become tree. In the right inner space only, the teachings can become reality. Right inner space means where all the root thought patterns of suffering are destroyed. All the root thought patterns are destroyed, where your inner space is fertile for experiencing the higher ideals and ideas. I tell you, start playing with your inner space to gain courage, to gather courage. Decide to tell yourself, try to play with it. Tell yourself, yes, with the inner space of completion, I am declaring, I am the space for my spouse listening to me. You will see miracles will happen. He or she will simply listen to you. I am the space for my boss granting me vacation. Go with that and play. Actually, only when you play with that space and see miracles happening, if you try 10 times, at least 8 times you will see miracles happening. Only when you see miracles happening, you will understand the power of the inner space. Don't go, I will go with this space, I will be failure. Then naturally you will be failure. That is a miracle. See, if you go, yes, I will go with this space, but even then I am going to be a failure. Then this is the space you are carrying. Then failure is again a miracle. Because you go with the space of failure, you attracted failure. Dhyan se suniye. Agar aap antar jhank kar dekhte hai, aap dekh payenge ki aapki har pratirodhi bhav aapke mool vichar dharana se hi janam lete hai. Understand the inner space you carry is such powerful inner space. That is Hiranyagarbha, means where the planets, worlds get created, worlds happen. Your inner space is so powerful, the worlds can be created or destroyed by your inner space. You may be individual, but your inner space is not individual. It is well connected with the whole universe. So anything you decide in your inner space becomes reality in the cosmos, reality in the life, reality in existence. So the essence of today's satsang, have right inner space to create your life that will always lead to enlightenment, inspiration, success in every level of your life. In every sphere of your life, every dimension of your life. I bless you all to experience this great principle of inner space, right inner space, and change the world through your word. Your word can change the world. Experience this extraordinary power in your life. Let you all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, and enriching with eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda.
Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, off Mysore Road, Bidadi, Bengaluru. Phone 08027279999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.